Hi Golden Eagles! In this video, you will learn how to use Schedule Planner to save time when creating your class schedule for the next term. Let's get started. First, go to calstatela.edu. Next, click on My Cal State LA. This will take you to a login page. Enter your username and password, then click Login. You will then click on Get, then Self-Service. Scroll down and click on Student Center. There are two ways to get to your schedule planner. One is through Degree Planner. For more information on how to use Degree Planner and Schedule Planner to plan your courses, please watch our other video titled Use Degree Planner to Stay on Track. For now, we will go through Student Center. Click on Schedule Planner, which is located under the drop-down menu. It will take you to a page where you need to click on Open Schedule Planner. In order for this to work, make sure you allow pop-up windows. It will open a new page where it asks to select the term you're registering for. Make sure you choose the correct one, then click on Save and Continue. If you have courses already set up from your Degree Planner, a blue box will appear and ask to load them to your Schedule Planner. In this video, we will show you how to add courses manually. Some features about Schedule Planner you should know about. You can go to Course Status, click on Change, and choose if you want to search courses by open classes only, open and full with waitlist for more flexible results, or open and full. In this case, we will choose open classes only. You can search for courses based on academic groups, meaning by a specific college. And you can also search through instruction modes. This allows you to choose if you'd like face-to-face courses, hybrid, or online. Let's add some courses. Let's say that next semester you need to take this set of courses. Click on Add Courses. You can search by subject, course attribute, or by instructor. Since we know the subject we need to take, let's search by subject. Let's look for Communication 1200. Notice that it will give you a course description with prerequisites needed to take the course, as well as the GE requirement the course fulfills. Go ahead and click on Add Course. Continue adding courses on the same page. Once all your courses have been added, click on the Back button. Notice that all your courses are now in the main Schedule Planner page. Once all your courses are there, click on Generate Schedules. This will give you all available schedules based on your selected courses. In this case, there are 220 schedules. You can compare schedules by checking the boxes and clicking Compare, or click on View. This will show you a layout of how your schedule would look. You can click on these arrows to toggle between the schedules. When you're viewing schedules, click on the blue info button. Look under notes to see if the course is reserved for a specific group of students. If it is, please note that you will not be able to take that particular section unless you are part of that group. If you can't take that section, look for a different section of the same course. Another useful feature when clicking on the info button is that Schedule Planner will let you know if two courses need to be taken together. This is called a co-requisite. When adding a co-requisite course, ensure that the section numbers match. If there are too many choices and you would like to narrow it down, you can add breaks. Click on Add Break. Let's say you would like to add a break because you cannot take courses in the evening due to your evening commute or work schedule. You can add a break from 7 to 11 p.m. and select weekdays. Click on Add Break. Click on Generate Schedules and it narrows down to 74 schedules. If you receive a message stating that there are no schedules available, make sure to read the conflicts. It could mean that you need to choose different courses or change your break time. Once you have chosen the schedule that works for you, click on Send to Shopping Cart. You will see a pop-up message stating that your schedule will be transferred to the shopping cart. Click OK. The next step is to return to your Get Student Center and click Enroll. Let's say you transfer the courses to the shopping cart, but notice that one of your courses is now closed. No worries, Schedule Planner has your back. Go back to Schedule Planner. Notice that it shows all of the courses in your shopping cart. Deselect the course that is closed. Then manually add the course again or select a different course. Click on Generate Schedules. Once you find the schedule that you prefer, click on Send to Shopping Cart. As you can see, all of your selected courses have moved to the shopping cart. Click on Proceed to Step 2 of 3 and Finish Enrolling. We hope this information was useful. If you have any questions, visit our website to see how you can connect with an advisor.